For this project, I'm going to show you how to turn a dollar store tablecloth into a super simple parachute that's easy to make and impressively effective. So whether you're launching rockets or throwing skyballs in the park, you'll be able to make an endless supply of canopies for all your aerial activities. Let's start this project with some plastic table covers. These rectangular ones are from the dollar store, and there are loads of different colors you could choose from, and as you might have guessed, I'm going with yellow. If you look closely at the ends, you should see that the material is smooth and folded over on one side, while the other side has all the straight cuts, and it's important to remember which is which. Now this needs to be trimmed down just a little, so measure 13 inches from the smooth end of the bundle, and double check that the side you're about to cut is the one with all the loose ends. I'm using an X-Acto knife and a straight edge to try and get a clean cut, but you could use a pair of scissors just as well. Now that it's trimmed, go ahead and unfold the tablecloth lengthwise, then cut a piece exactly 26 inches from one of the ends. You should end up with a rectangle that's 13 inches by 26 inches, and you'll find that a quick and easy way to mass produce these into parachute canopies is with a little origami. Start by folding the rectangle in half to form a square, and make sure the bottom right corner has the four loose ends. If it does, then put your pointer finger on the corner to hold it in place, and fold it point to point, forming an isosceles right triangle. Now measure up 5 inches from the bottom, double checking that the loose ends are on the right side, then go ahead and cut the bottom piece off. And you could use these scraps for making micro parachutes if you wanted to. At this point, unfold your triangle and you'll see a little square chunk missing from the bottom right corner. If you unfold it again 2 more times, you should end up with a giant yellow cross. That's awesome, but check this out. There's actually another layer underneath, which means you just made 2 of them without even realizing it. I cut up the rest of the tablecloth, which you can see made 8 separate canopies in about 3 minutes. So now that we've got all our patterns cut, the next step is to assemble them. Grab a piece of tape about 2 inches long and press just the upper left section of it to one of the corners like this. Now pull the other corner over and line up the 2 sides so you can tape them together, and you should see the edges match perfectly at the bottom. Alright, let's flip the canopy over and fold the other half of the tape around so we can stick it flat to the inside of the parachute as well. If you do the same thing with all 4 corners, you should see the canopy starting to take shape. Okay, we're ready to rig the parachute cording. For that I'm using this number 3 crochet thread I got from a local supercenter, but any other kind of string will probably work just as well. I also picked up some 1/4-inch braided elastic cording and a pack of number 7 barrel swivels from the fishing aisle. You'll see what those are for in just a minute. Now our parachutes only need 2 strings about 33 inches long, but in an effort to mass produce them for 8 parachutes at once, I strung out 16 lines in a zigzag pattern, then collected them all together into one long bundle so they could be cut at the same time. It's a good idea to mark both ends of the strings 1.5 inches from the bottoms, because these markings will make it a lot easier when it's time to attach them to the canopy. Cut the strings so they're exactly 33 inches long, and if you did it right, that should leave 1.5 inches on either end of the markings. Now to attach the lines to the parachute, we'll need to cut a small piece of tape and press it onto the string so the bottom of the tape lines up with the mark. Then attach the string to the inside of the parachute by pressing it flat to the plastic cloth, making sure the mark lines up at the very bottom. The bit of string at the top needs to be folded over and secured into place as well, so use a second piece of tape around 2 inches long and flatten the string down over top. Of course, the other end of the string gets attached the exact same way to the corner right beside it, and after you attach the second string to the other side, there's only one thing left to do. Bring 2 of the attachment points together so the marks on either end of the string match up perfectly, then pull the parachute strings completely straight. Now without letting go of the strings, carefully tie a knot near the end. After you've tied the other string the same way, line the 2 loops beside each other and thread them with some of the elastic cording. I found that tying a couple of square knots and pulling them really, really tight will make sure this connection never comes undone. Now simply trim the excess with a pair of scissors and tie one of the swivel hooks to the other end the same way. If you want, you can even attach barrel swivels to both ends of the elastic cording and make them any length you need. This way, if your lines get tangled to the point of frustration, they'll be easy to unclip and fix within seconds. Now just for fun, I went ahead and made 8 different parachutes with various colored tablecloths and used them to make a colorful set of skyballs. If you launch one high into the air, you'll see a little parachute opens up, which adds another dimension to the fun you can have outdoors. They're super fun and hardly take any time to make, so look for how to build these in another project video. Of course, my favorite way to use these simple chutes is with the homemade randomizer rocket we made in another video, and it only takes a couple of simple modifications to work with these rockets. First, make sure your elastic cording is tied securely to your parachute, then cut it off around 13 inches long. And secondly, instead of one swivel clip, I recommend using 2 to be extra sure your rockets come back safely. These simple chutes are lightweight, low cost, and look impressively professional considering what they're made from. Now packing your parachute is as simple as holding it in the center, then squeezing it all together and rolling it up. You might want to fold the material in half and give it another squeeze to get rid of any air, but essentially all you need to do is roll it up and wrap the strings around the outside, which will help hold the bundle together until it deploys. Well, now you know how to convert the humble plastic tablecloth into a boatload of parachute recovery systems. So whether you plan on making skyballs or launching rockets, you'll have a much better chance of recovering them undamaged. By the way, if you don't feel like building a rocket or crafting a set of skyballs, these parachutes can easily be modified to fit your favorite toys or action figures as well. Well, that's it for now. If you like this project, perhaps you like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com. Hey guys, this project is part of a design collaboration I did with my friends at sonicdad.com. Please check them out and subscribe to their YouTube channel. If you remember the collaboration we did last year with the Assassin's Micro Crossbow, then you'll understand why I chose Ritchie from the Sonic Dad team as my partner for building a rocket. He's a creative genius in all respects and has an amazing mind for thinking outside of the box. Together, Ritchie and I designed a really cool launch pad, the randomizer rocket, and a recovery parachute that all work impressively well. We've done around 50 launches so far, and he's already got detailed videos and instructions on how to make them at sonicdad.com. I highly recommend you support and subscribe to Sonic Dad because they're one of the channels I follow and these guys have my highest respect. I know them personally and they're on a mission to help people turn off the TV and go make something cool instead. Thank you for watching and supporting these projects. I appreciate you and I'm excited to see you around for the next project video. I'll talk to you then.